Hey yo, what is up guys? My name is Infinite Z, and first and foremost, I apologize for my microphone. I am in a different setup, so I may sound a little bit muffled or in a little closed environment. So I'm really sorry about that. And let's get on to today's topic, which is Black Ops 2, as you guys know from the title of the video. And it's going to be first impressions. As you guys know, Black Ops 2 got released yesterday, and I got the privilege to go get Black Ops and play it today, or yesterday. And so far I've played about 2 hours of Black Ops, and it's been a pretty good game so far. But on another note, I'd like to touch up on the gameplay. If you've never been on my channel, I don't record with an HD PVR yet. So, my gameplay is not as crisp or sharp as others, so you might want to excuse me on that. But, anyways, let's get started with my first impressions. And, first thing I noticed when I hopped on was the, connection. And, as you guys know, Modern Warfare 3, the connection was pretty horrible. It was horrific. It was like something coming out of a Hollywood movie. And, so far, I don't feel like that's the case in Black Ops 2. The connection isn't perfect. I will say that. It's not perfect. I have hopped on a couple of 6v6 matches where the connection, the connection kind of harmed me in a way because, bullets weren't registering. I was getting shot through corners, you know, stuff like that. And this was in a 6v6 environment. I haven't really played a lot of Ground War. I think I played about 2 games, so I don't really have a feel for the lag compensation or how it impacts the players in Ground War. Because as you guys know, in, what was it, like 99, it's a totally different game, concerning connection. It's very different. So, yeah, connection is it's pretty good as of now. We're gonna have to wait and see how it plays out in December, come Christmas time and come the holidays. But the second thing I noticed was the amount of time you take to drop the enemy. So in Modern Warfare 3, I believe that when you zapped on a person, you immediately just shut them down. You killed them as pretty fast, like within a second or something ridiculous like that. But in Black Ops, it was completely opposite. It took quite a long time to kill the person, and this is where Black Ops 2 comes in. Black Ops 2 is in the middle of both of these games, so try to imagine that. It's not as doesn't take as long to kill the person as in Black Ops, or it's not as fast as Modern Warfare 3. It's kind of like the sweet spot in between them. So that amount of time is pretty good in my opinion. It's not that bad, and it does take a little bit getting used to, and so far I think I'm getting used to it. So if I can do it, anybody can do it. But apart from that, I haven't played much. I think I have about 3 hours on Black Ops 2, and I'll make sure to play some of the multi-team type game matches and try to get some gameplay up from that. If you're not subscribed already, make sure to subscribe. I'll be making more Black Ops 2 commentaries, hopefully one tomorrow or the day after. And make sure to give me a like on this video, because it takes quite a while to make these. And yeah, that's about it guys. It's Infinitic Z, and I'm out. Peace. For me it was on the keypad instead of a drunken SMA. I'm foolish when I get pissed. Wake up, free draw, inbox, and get the gist. I want my heart on my wrist to the girl that I love on my contacts list. It's in my mind you're trending, and I wait and my heart's still pending. See you later on my newsfeed, don't leave me on voicemail please. All the boys you friended, seems like this contract's suspended. From the signal you are sending, got a feeling this is it. I want my heart on my wrist to the girl that I love on my contacts list. It's in my mind you're trending, and I wait on my heart.
the signal, you are sending out a feeling. This is it.